how does the government respond that the Philippines ranks very low? It's 52nd out of 53 economies, kumbaga second to the last in the global study, okay, of resilience. How do you respond to that, Secretary? Because clearly their indicators considered the percentage of people have been vaccinated, the severity of the lockdowns, flight capacity, vaccinated travel routes, 1 month cases per 100,000. How do you defend the Philippines with this Bloomberg study that we're doing poorly?
Well, you know, I'm sorry to say this, Karen. If you look at the parameters that you enumerated, these are so skewed to a high vaccination rate. And, you know, I will be the first one to admit that we don't have enough vaccines to give a population protection rate of at least 50%. We're only 3+% for fully immunized individuals. So you're right. People covered by vaccines were only 3.2%. Why? Because the rich countries have already secured 80% of the global supply of vaccines. And that leaves us among the middle income countries scrambling and almost begging for vaccines. And they're already talking about the luxury of a third dose, booster dose. And to me, this is unethical because the world, many of the citizens of the world are still without vaccines, no? And then you're now talking about third, a booster dose. I cannot fathom that point, no? And then lockdown severity. And lockdown severity is also contingent upon the adequate vaccination protection. Flight capacity, the same. The vaccinated travel routes, the same. No? But, however, if you look at the other metrics, month cases per 100,000, we're okay. We're blue na tayo. Mataas tayo. Ibig sabihin, mataas ang ranking, ang rating natin, pero mababa yung ranking natin because the lower you rank, the better your response is. For example, 1 month case fatality rate, we're actually 2% for the last month. But if you look at the community, we're 1.7%, even lower. Death per million, we are 221. Ang ranking natin, 113th tayo. That's okay. Kaya nga hindi nga tayo
rest. So you feel the study is unfair?
Yeah, it is very unfair. And it is only showing that those countries that have already been vaccinated and reached a population protection of more than 50%. They're saying, "Oh, we're okay now. You can come. You know, we're ayos na kami rito. Our doors are open. Balik na kayo." That's unfair. That's very unfair. And I'm really, pissed with this. No? Kasi hindi naman tama.
Okay, I was surprised that you said that. I'm really pissed with this. All right.
No, I'm sorry. It's just that that's my emotion gets the matter.
Just my last question, because we also have Senator Risa, but Secretary, what action will the DOH take? Will you be writing a formal letter to Bloomberg? I'm curious, or this is it. You voiced out your feeling.
Well, we can exercise the option of writing them a letter and questioning how skewed the parameters are towards a vaccination coverage, of a high vaccination coverage in particular. So there has to be a better balance, no? Hindi mo pwedeng puro sila nga may hawak ng bakuna eh. Sila may pinakamalaki, sila ang tagagawa eh. And yet, despite that, you see some countries, their Delta variants are really spiking, no? But although, of course, admittedly, their hospitalization rates are down, no? Which is very important. So, vaccines is very important. But while we don't have the sufficient protection as of yet, our PDITR strategy, our minimum public health standards, ito po, nakikiusap po ako sa akin mga kababayan, na laban na po ito ay laban ng bawat Pilipino. We are not helpless. Kaya po natin ito, napatunayan na po natin dito sa NCR, dalawang beses, napabagsak na po natin ng mga kaso dahil po tayo sumunod sa face shield, face mask, social distancing, pag-iwas po ng mga makukulob na mga lugar o kulang sa ventilasyon at ang pangangalaga po sa kalusugan ng bawat Pilipino ang taglay na protection laban sa COVID.
On that note, Secretary Francisco Duque, I want to thank you for joining me on Headstart, and I do hope you come back again because we have a lot to discuss still as this is an ongoing story. But thank you so much, Secretary, for your time this morning. Much appreciated. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. In behalf of the Department of Health, Karen, and I'd like to extend my regards to the good Senator Risa Ontiveros, who has been very supportive of all the health-related bills that have been successfully passed in Congress. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much.